alchemy proved the ranked theorem in general. It looks rather complicated at first sight. We can, however, split up the proof in three separate steps, and those separate steps are not that difficult. Furthermore, these steps are nice examples of how a proof works in linear algebra, so in this video you learn both proof of the ranked theorem and you see a few examples of the methodology used to give a proof. You can use the same methodology if you want to prove other statements. So, what was the ranked theorem again? If you have a linear transformation from V to W, a dimension of V has to be finite, say equal to n, then the kernel of T is a subspace, so it has a basis, V1 up till Vk. You could add vectors to that to get a basis of V, so a basis of V, V1 up till Vk, and Vk plus 1 up till Vn. And we only had to show that those last vectors, if you transform them, form a basis for T. So if we have that, we are done. And we have the rank equals the number of vectors over there, n minus k, and the nullity of equals the number of vectors over here, k, and n minus k plus k equals n. So then we are done with the statement. But still, we have to show that those tvk plus 1 up to tvn form a basis for the range of t. So that means that we have to show three things. First of all, if you got a span over here for a minute h, just to make the notation a bit smaller, then we have to show that h is contained in the range of t, and vice versa, that the range of t is contained in h. So together, we would have h equals the range of t. But first we show that h is contained in the range of t. So how do you show something like that? You have to take some arbitrary vector in h, and you have to show that it is also in the range of t. So let us take a y in h arbitrarily. That means y is in h, so it's in the span of those vectors over here. So y is a linear combination of t vk plus 1 up to t vn. That's what we have over there. Now, we have a linear transformation, that's important, so you can take the t outside. So, y equals the t of this large vector. And can we find some x? It's t of some x. Well, what is this x? Well, x then equals ck plus 1, vk plus 1 up till cn vn. But this is a linear combination of vk plus 1 up till vn, which are basis vectors of V. So this x over here is in fact in V. So what you have shown now is that you can find an x such that the t of x is this y. So that means that this y is indeed in the range of t, because that's exactly what is the defining property of the range. You are in the range if you can find an x such that t of x equals y. And that's the case over here, because we have found this x. So that's the first part, that h is contained in the range of t. Then we need to show the other one, the range of t is contained in h. I use a similar argument, but now you start with picking a vector over here, y in the range of t, arbitrarily, and you have to show that it is in h. So that means that you have to show that if you have a vector in the range of t, that can be written as a linear combination of tvk plus 1 up till tvn. So how are we going to do that? Well, y is in the range of t now, so you know that there is some x in v such that t of x equals y. Now, we have a basis of v over here, this long set, v1 up to vk, and then vk plus 1 up to vn. We know that x is in v, so x is in a combination of v1 up to vn, and that's what we have written over here. Now, we can compute the t of x. T of x is the t of this huge expression x. And now again we use the linearity. Linearity is really important here. And we can just split it up into c1 tv1 plus c2 times tv2, etc., etc., up till cn tvn. And now we use that this tv1, tv2, etc., that they are all in a null space. So all those terms are just zero, they cancel out. So what is left is ck plus 1 tvk plus 1 up till cn tvn. So what's left is that, in fact, our t of x is a linear combination of TV k plus 1 up till TVN. So ry is a linear combination of TV k plus 1 up till TVN. So that means that y is in the span of those things, which means that y is in H. So if y is in the range of t, then y is also in H. So that means that the range of t is contained in H. And that proves the first statement, because the range of t is contained in H, H is contained in the range of t. It can only be true if the range of t is A. So that was the first statement, the first part. Now, last part is to show that those factors are independent, in order to show that you have a basis. Well, that's fortunately a bit easier. So how do you show that a set is independent? Well, you look at the equation ck plus 1 tv vk plus 1 up till cn t vn equals 0. And you wonder why this equation has only the trivial solutions, or maybe more solutions. Well, again, use linearity. See, you use this linearity all the time. This only holds for linear transformations. You can take out the t everywhere and write this as one big factor, t of rubbish equals the zero factor. But that's only true if this rubbish inside the t is in the kernel of t. Now, we know what the kernel of t is. You have a basis. So that means that this ck plus 1, vk plus 1 up till cn vn is in the kernel of t. So it has to be a linear combination of v1 up till vk, because the basis of the kernel of t is set v1 up till vk. So any factor in this kernel can be expressed as linear combination of v1 up till vk, as you see over here. Now you can put all these all these factors to the right, sorry. So you have a 0 on one side, and then c1 v1 up till ck vk on the other side, and all the other ones equals 0. And now you use the property that v1 up till vn are a basis of v, so they are independent. So the only solution of this equation over here, due to the independence of v1 up till vn, is c1 is 0, c2 is 0, etc. up till cn is 0. So the only solution of this equation is that all ck are 0. But that means that our original ck over there also were all 0. So that means that the original equation also only has the trivial solution. The fact that c1 up till ck is also 0 doesn't even matter. Our first original equation also only has a trivial solution, which means that tv k plus 1 up to tvn are independent. And then we're done. Then we know that we have an independent set that spans the range of t. So that means that we have a basis for the range of t. And that is what we needed to prove.